Yes.
Okay.
Finally. I don't know what's up. I tried two phones. I tried different internets, three internets, and now I'm on LTE. So
okay. Now I hear you really well. So if you guys can also hear well.
Still hear. Through all this.
I don't know. For the past, I think, 1 hour, we've been working on this, but somehow it just happened that internet decided to make us go through this. So sorry, guys, about that, but I think it's fine.
That's great. That's what they would say. That's what's up with the internet.
Well, now we can continue. So cool.
Okay, great.
Yeah, so welcome back again.
Thank you.
For those of you who missed that part, Tahmina and I, we studied in Azerbaijan in Baku at the International School of Azerbaijan, TISA. If anyone's from TISA at the moment, hello, guys. And after TISA, Tahmina went to States first, or did you take gap year, right? States.
The gap year was in the States, yeah.
Ah, okay, so you took the gap year. She'll tell you about her education background, but the coolest part is that she's one of the people who went actually into acting, filmmaking, and so that's why it's like a very inspiring story she has to tell us today. So let's hear from you. Let people know who you are.
Everyone had the brains not to go into acting.
No, that's like courage. That's crazy.
I mean, like, brains isn't like, this is such a hard profession to be at, and there's so little guarantee that you're gonna make it. So
that's what I mean. It's such a, like, it's not an easy field, which I'm sure you'll tell us about it. But when I look at it, and it maybe sometimes it just looks so easy or seems easy, but there's so much, like, the steps actually that she had to take, and the things that you had to do. So I'd really like you to tell about it. So maybe you can start from school and to university, how you chose and what you decided to study.
Sure. Before we start, is this live on my page too? I've never seen live. I've never done live stuff.
I'm not sure. I think no.
Okay, whatever. That's fine. Just curious.
Guys, we're not going to get into technical.
No. Just to tell you what's kind of to sum up what I was saying earlier, I was 17 when I left and I took a gap year to study acting in Los Angeles. And then after that, when I was 18, I went to college and I got a degree in film studies and creative writing. And since I was 17, I was just taking classes in Los Angeles, like just really good acting studios with great acting teachers. And I've kind of been pursuing that since then. And you asked me earlier before we were disconnected for the 10th time. You asked me when I decided I wanted to do that. I think I knew since I was really young. I just didn't know it was a real profession. I thought it was just something that, because I don't really think in Azerbaijan we talk about it, especially at that time. And like, it's not really something that people see as a real profession. From, like, you see it in movies and stuff, but I don't think I ever thought it was like a thing you do without doing other things on the side. And but then once I realized that that was legit, I was like, well, that's kind of what I want to do. I've always wanted to do that. And then you talked about the drama TISA class. We had four people in our class, four. So I had like, it was four girls. And I think I was, I wrote a play in IB1, and that was like, done, you know, with the four characters. Two characters had to be male because, you know, we were like girls dressed up as males. It was really funny. And that was about it. And then I kind of, since then, really, since I started pursuing acting, I've started also writing, and I started directing, and I started like producing. And that's kind of what's been happening.
Oh wow, God. Yeah, I do remember that, like, at school. I know you started like from school, she was really into drama and acting, and you're so right. Like, it was thinking about going into acting and filming, it was something, I don't know, not something like we were planning. I don't know how to explain it. It's really hard, but it's just, we had to think about some career, some like job. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, it is like when people ask me, I think how I went into it, I think for me, it's always been something that I thought of. There's nothing else that I feel like I would be as passionate and good at, and, you know, I was also, it helps that I was, I think, 17, a little bit naive, and I would still do it. I'm not saying I would change my mind, but I think when you're somewhat naive, you like just go there and you're like, I can do it, I'll do it. And you're not like seeing just how difficult it is. But, and I'm glad I'm doing it. I'm still happy to do it very much so. I wouldn't change a thing, but it is something that is very risky. Mm-hmm. And it's, very, you know, not a lot of people understand risks that come with it. I think it's easy. It looks quite easy from the outside, but it's tough. I mean, me and my friends, you know, my friends are all in the film industry, and it's a struggle. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But so when you decided to go in the filming industry, did you like, what kind of reactions did you have from friends or like families? How did they look at it? I mean,
they thought I was something. I think they thought that I would be done with that in a year or two. Oh. I think they thought that, like, you know, she wants to give acting a try and then she'll be over it and she'll pursue a real career. And I think when they saw that, I was like, nope, like, that's what I'm doing. They kind of like, okay, there's nothing we can do about it. My family is very supportive. I don't have any problems with my family. I mean, look, do they wish I had a different career? Sure, but it's not for their own sake. I think they're just realizing how much rejection is in my profession, how much... Mm-hmm. How hard it is, and it's more that they're worried about my own sake. They don't really care about what it, you know, reflects on them, if some can say that, because they're just very good, sweet people that just want the best for me.
Yeah.
But I think my friends were all like sure, like that was obvious to them. The people that went to TESA with me, the people that kind of were closest to me, I think they knew that that was something that was coming. They secretly, like, even I wasn't very open about my love for acting, but those that were closest to me, they knew that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
True. Wow, that's great. We have like so much, and I prepared so many questions, which I'm also interested in. So if you guys also will have, just like think about it, and you can write in the comment section. I'll just ask while she talks.
Oh,
and so you studied for a bachelor's degree.
Yeah.
So can you tell a little about us, like how was it for you, and what was it like after graduation? What did you expect? And what did you actually face?
I expected that you land in Hollywood and someone discovers you.
I think you're almost there, though. You're there.
No, I actually, you know, it's funny because I didn't really expect that. I was that naive and stupid. But I did think that it was going to be easier. I will tell you that. I think I did think that I was more unique than I actually am. Because you come to LA, there's a lot of people.
I mean, I'm not laughing that the thing, but it's so true.
You
just think that way. I mean, why not?
An actor and is watching it or will watch it. I'm not trying to persuade anyone. Look, I'm still doing it. That means I still have belief in myself and I still know that this is something I want to do. I'm not stopping until I'm like however long. Like, that's not something I'm saying I will stop doing, but I'm just trying to be realistic, and I'm going to tell you that there's a lot of people in LA that are very talented and good looking. And I think you just have to have the persistence to keep doing it, which is what I'm doing. I'm not saying I'm going to stop doing it, but you do have to be a little bit more realistic. Like, I remember I came back and someone asked me, they're like, why don't you just go on a Gossip Girl audition? I'm like, you guys realize how auditions work? Like, it's not you just line up in a line and you walk in and act and then they discover you. Like, you have to have an agent, you have to have a manager, you have to first like get the audition. And getting the audition is already so difficult because there's already so many people.
Yay!
Next question before we run out of service or whatever.
Oh my. So yeah, so you're saying like of course we all think like we're gonna, doesn't matter, I think it's not just acting, but like even if you're some software engineer or like I don't know, you study business, when you get out of it university, you just think that you're gonna land some kind of a really cool awesome job, or you're gonna land in Google, Facebook, something like that. Well, some of us do, that's different.
Well, my cousin Sona, she did.
Sona. We're gonna talk about Sona.
Yeah, later. That girl is just, yeah,
definitely. She's gonna be coming here to talk about her journey, how she managed that, but that's a different story. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's true. But in acting, like, What was the job search like for you? I mean, were you already preparing yourself? You said you had a gap year, so you went to Baku to film. So if you can tell us about that part.
Well, I didn't take, I took the gap year to study acting. Okay. I took a semester gap to make a movie.
Okay.
That was in my, when I was 19, I think, or 20 years old. And I did that after I wrote the script. So I wrote the script to that movie and I had that be funded. And then I came to film the movie, which was a really great opportunity. I mean, that was amazing. That's something that was so, so, so great. And then I was, yeah, I took that and that film happened. And then I went back to the United States and I finished college. So when you're in college, the tricky thing about it, being an actor and going to university at the same time, you can't really audition while you're in college. Auditions are like in the middle of a day. They're like, they send you, if you manage to get an audition through your agent or your manager or on your own, you don't get to pick the time really. Like they send you a slot and you basically approve the slot or you didn't, you know, denied, but then you're like, you have a chance of losing on this opportunity. So if you're in college and you're trying to be an actor and you're getting a lot of auditions, it's really tricky. You might have to at one point choose what you want to do because it's hard. But for me, it was kind of like that too. And I was, you know, at the time I was waiting for in the United States, it's a little tricky. Like if you want to be getting legit jobs, you can't just be on a student visa. Mm-hmm. You have to have a work permit. And so I had to wait till I graduated. I got my work permit. And then I was really able, I started auditioning towards, really seriously auditioning towards the end of my, when I already got the work permit, which was towards the end of, I think my senior year, mm-hmm. I think that was. But before that, I was just like really rigorously studying and taking a lot of acting classes. I was writing a lot. I made the movie in Azerbaijan. And then finally, when I was able to audition, I had a manager. I was with an agency and they would send me out. And that's when I really kind of, yeah, started going at it. Mm-hmm. It was the end. No, I think it was during the spring season. So I think it was like it was shot March, April, May, and I wrote that the season before that. Sorry, so light enough. I shot that. I wrote that in the fall, and I had that really was a really fast turnaround, and I had that made in the spring, and we shot I think for 2 months, and then that. But I was, you know, I was. This was my first feature film. I wrote it. I think I was like 18 when I wrote it. I was 19, so it was very cool to be able to have done that. That's nobody, you know, yeah, not everyone.
It was 18, 19, making her first movie. I mean, how cool is that? Like, I don't know if you realize it, but it's really cool. And it's like, at that age, like, I don't know what most of us were thinking, probably hanging out, going, I don't know. But it's amazing. She filmed and she played in this movie as well. I don't know if you guys have seen Inner City in English, Içer Şehir, mm-hmm. In this area, let's say.
Bu melodiyada sanki şehrimizin kalbinin sesi duyulur. Seven, eziyet çeken.
Başa düşmürüm bu sene eve lazımdı. Piyano çalacaksan.
So I wrote that when I really started discovering my love for writing and when I kind of started realizing that I really wanted to make movies as well as in Azerbaijan. Like I think before that I wasn't sure, but then I realized I actually like as a writer, I really want to share stories that I feel are important back then. And, you know, I think as every year you grow as a person and you have different perspectives and you have different things, or you mean it's emotions, your whatever happens in your life is reflected in your writing. And at that point, I think for me it was I think it was like a sense of isolation and a sense of being a little bit kind of what you said, like, you know, at 17, 18 you feel like, you know, what people are doing at 17, 18. I always felt like at 17, 18 I was a little bit like somewhere else with what I wanted in life. Mm-hmm. Like, not that I was ahead, but I just had completely different interests. And I think I wanted to write about that. So I wrote this movie about this young girl who feels, you know, she feels like she's a little different. She doesn't really connect with her peers and she falls in love with this older man who's a piano teacher. And I just try to show that, like, you know, love doesn't really, age doesn't really matter in love, and he's kind of an outsider too. So it was really a love story that I wrote. It kind of like was shot a little different, but it was essentially a love story. And I wrote that, I think, when I was 18 and 19. And by the time it was out, I think I was 20. I think so. Yeah.
That's crazy. That's like for me, it's like, oh, different work. And how was it like working on the script part? How long would you like, can you tell us like how it actually works? Do you just like sit down, think about it, write this?
Yeah, writing is rewriting. That's what they say. And it's just like, you know, you have a first draft, you have an idea. Every writer has their own technique. Every writer writes in their own way. For me, it's, you know, I go with the flow a lot, and then obviously, like, I send it to people that I really trust and whose feedback I want to hear, and then they send me notes, and then it's like reworking it. If you're in a class, you can workshop it with the teacher, you workshop it with other students. But I think the main thing is that if you have an idea and you really stick to it and you really believe in it, you're just going to find a way to work with it. It's just the approach to it is different for every person. Yeah. But I think I wrote it in a pretty, that was like probably the fastest script I've ever written. After that, it's always been a little bit slower, but it's also because I think I didn't have, I was just like very concentrated. Mm-hmm. And after time, like you get less concentrated.
And did you have like any challenges when you were filming or writing?
Yeah.
Was it like difficult for you?
Or being a lead in a movie. That's a big thing, going from zero to something so big. Mm-hmm. An opportunity I wouldn't be able to get in Los Angeles. And that's why I think it was, that's why I really encourage people to not try to see it all as like, let me move to LA and pursue a career. I mean, definitely move somewhere where you can get the education and definitely live there if you want to live there. I have nothing against people that want to live abroad. But I do think that if you want to be in the arts, if you come from a country or a place where it's still developing, I would encourage you to kind of first start out there, like seek out the people, the best people in your country, and try to work with them, because that can really, you can go from being a nobody to being an elite in a movie in Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. It's a different, it's just, I mean, sometimes that happens. Look, I've auditions for things which are pretty big, but did I end up getting them? No, big actors got them, you know, and that's how it works there. So I'm just encouraging people to not right away try to run away. True. Because of our ideal past, because of our history, because of our religion, and like, you know, the secular part of it. So I just think there's so much to be told, and you know, as a writer, write what you know best. And I just think that it's right away trying to run away from that is not always wise, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. If you really want to, like, I say that to filmmakers in Azerbaijan who are like, oh, you know, if I was in LA, I'd be famous by now. A lot of people say that,
but
and I'm just
not really dying. How it works.
You would see that there's some really, really talented people there that can't get a break. It's tough. It's a tough industry, and it's much easier to break in these countries at the beginning. I'm not saying like stick to these countries forever, but I'm just saying if you really want to have something good, you know, it's not going to be like Avengers big, but it's going to be something that people will notice if it's good enough. Mm-hmm. And then you can work your way up from there. And for me, it's been like, I don't live in Baku, but I love returning here. I love working with filmmakers here because I'm really connected to them, and I'm really excited to work with these people. As much as, you know, I'm still doing stuff and I'm still auditioning and I'm still loving my work there. But I think you know, you shouldn't forget that there's a platform here as well, even though it's less so, but it's still there.
No, I totally agree. I mean, when you realize, like, after graduation, especially international students, those people, like, if you go abroad and if you realize that it's not working here, then just take a step back. And it's okay after graduation not to land in the like top place or top movie or the whatever, it's the TV series. It's okay. I mean, you come back.
It's so. I think it's in our heads that we read these stories. Oh, you know, like this famous person was spotted on the street. Like,
yeah. Well, tell us a little about that. How did they get spotted?
They had a lot of things happen to them. It's very rare. I mean, models, probably, yeah. Models, that's probably something that happens. But as an actor, it's like a legend, urban legend, you know, like you hear these things, but do they actually happen? I personally don't really know any of my friends that have done it or people really. I mean, most of them have to work their butts off.
I also have this question, and we have a question from Fira. Can you tell us about the greatest moment in your film career? And I have something like similar to that. If you can tell us an interesting moment while making the movie. So
greatest moment in my film. Well, I think because, you know, I think it's a big thing to have your film be made, funded, something that you wrote. And I was 18, 19, which is very young. And I think that was a really big thing for me. I mean, to be able to do that and be given this opportunity, to be trusted with this opportunity, to like have someone see your script and say it's good enough to be made, that was huge for me. I would say that. And like, I think over there's, you know, there's just in every stage in my film career, there's something greater that happens, and I'm growing, yeah.
And so, what about the movie or like while filming, do you have any like interesting moments that made you like really remember or connect? Do you have something?
You know, I think it's about the people you work with, and sometimes you just work with such great people, and feeling this community of people that are as passionate and as in love with what they do as you are, and playing off each other as an actor, like it's such an incredible feeling to have that support from your actor friends, from a director, from a writer. And I think every time I do that and I'm on set with these people, some of them like I never see again, like these are just people I meet on the day of, I think that's just always been such a great experience to connect in that way with other actors or just any people. And I think that, honestly, that's one of my favorite parts about being an actor and a writer and a director, is that I just get to meet so many amazing people. I really do, yeah.
But that reminds me, so like knowing us, most people from Azerbaijan, you know, they speak two languages, Azeri, Russian, it's like our thing. Mm-hmm. And then you're also fluent in English. Now that I think about it, was it difficult for you to act in like in Azeri? Because you have to like, I don't know, like do you find it difficult, the language barrier? I'm not sure how it is for you, but sometimes like, since I lived abroad for such a long time, and then I most of the time speak English, so I find it sometimes difficult speaking in Azeri or Russian. So
I had to take class. I mean, it's hard because I do live in LA and I've been living there for almost 7 years now, and I did go to an American speaking school, so you know that I can't. Even Russian for me right now is
right.
A little bit hard.
Yeah. Like if I'm an actual speaker, I'm just like sometimes just really lost.
Yeah. I think it's more any language aside from English. And it was hard, but I did come probably 2 months before we started filming, and I took classes every day, and I worked on, I mean, people probably still noticed an accent at the end of the day, but like, you know, I can't get rid of that. I'm not someone who speaks Azeri every day. I did my best, and you know, I think it was good enough. But originally, in my screenplay, the character, she is a Russian-speaking, Azeri-speaking girl, which is kind of what I am. Yeah. But they have changed that because, you know, it's just like film stuff that you have to change around.
Stuff.
But originally, that was the idea. It was hard. It's hard to speak in a different language in a movie, absolutely, because your voice is your tool as an actor. And to not be able to use the tool that you're comfortable with, that's hard.
So which language do you feel the most comfortable and like the most confident in? Would that be?
Oh, English.
Yeah.
English, definitely, yeah. I feel comfortable writing. I write my screenplays in English.
In English,
and
okay.
And then translate it into a different language, yeah.
Okay.
So. I think especially being in LA and being around actors, and because of how difficult it is to be in this industry, when people remind me of that and they say like, that's a big deal that you wrote something that got made when you were 19 or 20, only then I'm reminded of it. Mm-hmm. But I don't see it as a big deal just because I don't know, like I'm trying not to take it for granted, but it's definitely like, it's a tough thing to do. And there's a lot of great scripts out there that are not getting made. I feel like that's why I'm trying to point it back to take opportunity in your own country. Mm-hmm. If you can make some, like, I don't think that at 19, even if I had the best screenplay in the world, it would have been very difficult for me to make a movie now in the United States with zero experience. I mean, it would have to be such a unique whatever idea for it to be made, but it's tough. Like, it's definitely tough, and to be able to kind of be seen in that light and to have a movie made out of it, it's a big deal. And I don't think that would have been possible if I was in the United States now.
That's true.
Yeah.
And so I was watching... I watched the trailer, of course, on YouTube a couple of times again, because I really loved it. And what about some of your other projects? You've done a couple more projects. If you can tell us what you've done, where you've done about them.
As a writer or as an actor?
Both. You do so much. Just tell whichever.
Well, on acting, you know, it's kind of like the stuff I auditioned for in Los Angeles. I've been a little bit in TV, a lot, you know, some films I've worked with, in theater, just stuff like that, which has been great, all really great experiences. For writing, I wrote two shorts before I wrote the feature. After that, I did two more shorts that got made. So total like five things that I've written that got made, one of them being a feature. And the short that just came out is something for the first time where I directed.
Yeah, this and is actually, I have a little surprise for you. I didn't mention this to her. So during this time, quarantine, we're stuck at home, you know, like working remotely. Yeah. And we were like with my husband, we're searching for like TV series, movies, like we work from time to time. So I don't know. I totally like didn't even like realize or think about it. I started watching The Blacklist.
Oh, yeah.
I do remember hearing about it a long time ago, but I totally forgot. So I'm just watching it like naturally. Yeah, and we're so into it with my husband. Like, we just can't stop watching it. And we came to a season, to an episode where Tahmina is playing. That was like, what? I know this girl.
Yeah. You know what's so funny? You know what's so funny is that I like haven't seen that show before that. I mean, I've heard of it obviously, but I remember when I got the audition, I was like, okay, like it's a show I've heard of, and I did the audition, it was really fast. I sent the tape and then I had to fly to New York to do it. It's my manager obviously got me the audition, but I remember like I didn't realize how big that show was until after like it people I haven't big. Spoken to like 10 years are just like, hey Tahmina, I just saw you in The Blacklist.
Guys, if you haven't watched it, like first of all, it's like you get so attached to it. I don't know, like I couldn't stop watching it, and I'm just like messaging everyone just to watch it, and then I come to episode, I'm like, Tahmina. Hi. Hello. That's her. I think that's her. Let her play it again.
Tahmina. Yeah, but it's like a blink and you'll miss me type of thing. So
I recognize her, so just saying. And if you just like start watching it, just like I don't know, you get so attached. And we actually recently finished it, and I really want to tell you about this as a surprise. Like, she's there, guys. Maybe you'll start watching from here.
It's a lot of fun.
It was great. And like even the last episode we watched it like the other day, unfortunately due to COVID, like they had to it's very difficult for actors like at the moment, and mm-hmm. you can reflect better on it. But mm-hmm. what happened with Blacklist is that they couldn't film the last episode. Actually, normally they film 22 episodes mm-hmm. for the TV series, and they couldn't, so they had to cut down on 19th. But for that, they had to mix it with animation. Came out pretty interesting and different, but they sent out their messages. Of course, this is the best they could do.
Unfortunately. Yeah, it's still going, right? That show is still going.
Yes, it's still going. You're at season three, and
Four.
I think it's four.
Four.
It's either four, three or four. Like, I remember it was one of them. But she's there, guys, The Blacklist.
Check it out. I'm there for 5 seconds.
Well, it's a great start, I think. Like, to be honest, to be filmed and already even playing that kind of role and being on Netflix. Ta-ta! So, there you go.
Yeah.
And, So, moving on about your... I had a look at some of your really good interviews. By the way, you guys can check it out on YouTube. She gives some really nice topics, TED Talks. And in one of the interviews, you mentioned that going abroad and then coming back helped you to observe your people, your community better, and it allowed you to reflect better on what to do. So what are like these some of the things that you observed or learned while coming back that helped you to make the film?
I think just when you're not away, I think when you're away from anything and you're kind of submerged in a different society, in a different environment, you're able to observe things better that are happening on the other side because you're away from it. I think when you're in it, you're a little bit, you're kind of like swimming in it and you don't see how different it is from anything else. And leaving has allowed me to see just how different things are to here. Our culture, both good things and bad things. That's really allowed me to write things that I feel are unique. Yeah. I mean, my short is kind of about that too. It's just being a woman in our society, how different it is.
What are your plans for future in filming industry? What are you?
Well, I actually came to Baku because I was going to film a feature with this amazing filmmaker. I'm not going to talk about it now just because, you know, because of it, things have paused and now I'm just waiting for them to restart everything so we can actually go back to shooting. But we need to be on location, and the location is outside of Baku, and we can't go outside of Baku because the roads are closed. You can't really go to those places. So I came here for that reason. And I came here, and literally a week or 2 weeks after, this is when everything started. That's when the quarantine started. Everything got shut down. And I'm really excited about that because we've been working on that project with this incredible filmmaker for 6 years now. For 6 years, we've been trying to get it funded. I mean, he's big. He's a really well-known filmmaker in Azerbaijan and, you know, just really critically acclaimed and wonderful. And I've wanted to work with him ever since before. And we got our green light. And this happened, so it's a bummer. I mean, the film industry overall in the world is shut down right now. In LA, I think, actually, I was just told today that they're going to restart everything in a month or something. There's going to be a lot of rules, but they're going to restart. And then, you know, my short film, this is the year that my short film gets into film festivals, and I can't even attend them, and they're, like, being postponed or being moved online. So it's affecting all of us, definitely. Film industry is, you know, also being affected. Yeah. But these are my plans. I want to make the feature. I mean, hopefully once this is over, we can make the feature. I didn't write that. I'm the actor in it. But I've been attached to it for 6 years now. It's a really great project with a really great filmmaker. And then in the future, what I see for myself, probably directing a feature. That's something I would really like to do next at some point.
Yeah, do you want to do more? Like, do you want to be involved more in the acting part or directing? What is?
Oh, I don't put limitations on myself.
That's great. Like, yeah, you know, that really makes me actually, like, it also got me excited and inspired, to be honest, because I heard you say in one of the interviews as well how you're so open to experimenting and exploring, whether it's directing or acting or writing, all of that. Because sometimes I think we're told, or like it's seen as a weird thing when you're like trying to enter this and that and that, trying. But I see it as like an exploring different fields and like trying, yeah, showing. I'm like, you know what I mean? Like people see it as a negative thing that, well, why don't you just go with one thing? But hey, if you can do that.
That's such an old-fashioned way of seeing things. I mean, just if you look at so many even shows these days, I mean, the creators of those shows are the lead actors in that show. And also, why, if you like doing all these things, there's no one putting a limit on you. Like, I mean, most actors that I know or that, you know, I really look up to, they either produce or they direct or they write. There's really just no, yeah, there's no limit to what you can really do for yourself. So I'm interested in all of it. I'm interested in writing. I'm probably more interested in writing about things that are happening in Azerbaijan. Like, I'm very interested in writing and directing more here. And when it comes to acting, I just, anywhere in the world, I just love doing it. Yeah.
That's good. I totally support that. Because I'm one of those, like, I don't know, people I've seen, like, I like to explore different fields and try things. So, and I'm completely open. And I encourage actual people. I don't see a reason to limit or to be stuck. Yeah, even if you studied in a different field. So, yeah, definitely on that. And so here's a question on about yourself while acting. Did you ever doubt yourself? Like, did you ever have the fear that you won't be able to do it right?
Of course. Are you kidding me? Yes. Yeah. Are you kidding me?
I don't know, you like can build confidence already.
No, I don't come off like that, but I will tell you this. If any filmmaker, any artist you meet, they doubt themselves. I mean, they might not show it. They might not say it, but oh my goodness, yes. Also, in an industry where you're being constantly rejected, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, you just kind of have to have a good support system and a good steady mind that also has probably other things to ground the mind in order to be just clear-minded and realize that it's not about you, it's just you're not right for the part, but there's something that is there that's right for you. But absolutely, there's a lot of doubt, there's a lot of rejection, there's a lot of wanting to quit. Yeah.
And how do you deal with those moments? Like, how do you get yourself up and say that, okay, you know what, I'm just going to continue? I do have like, to face it in real life, like doing certain small things. It sometimes gets demotivating. Sometimes I'm just like lying down. You know, it's really hard. How do you motivate yourself?
I mean, you find your something in your life that grounds you. It's either a spiritual life, or it's something else in your life that you can love as much as you love acting or filmmaking. A great support group that will always lift you up. I think people that lift you up, that's very important. And I'm very lucky to have that. I have a great community of friends there. I have a great, family. So I've always had people that would make sure that I get up every time I complain and every time I say I'm done with it. But also, you know what, Farida, like, I think for me, it's always been just when I wanted to quit, I've asked myself, like, what are you going to do? And for me, it's always been like, there's nothing I love doing as much as I love doing this. So in a way, I don't really have a choice. So because this is the only, I mean, I could go do something for sure and earn more money and probably have a more steady job, but it's not something I would love doing. And I think for me, I always believe that you got to do what you love in life. And I've also been given the opportunity to pursue that. I know that not everyone has been. You know, I think people think that actors are really confident. It's not true. I mean, sure, I think we don't have stage fright. Like, that's probably, I mean, even we do. I think actors do. It's just you don't really see it. And also, I know a lot of people who are really shy, but then when they're in front of a camera, they're like not shy at all. It's just, it's a different way of kind of, I think, being that people don't really understand. But you don't have to be like a super outgoing person to be able to be confident in front of a camera. I'm like an introvert. Like, you can't say that from the way I talk to you and how social I am. But I've enjoyed this quarantine, you know, like, I'm quite an introvert, and I spend a lot of time on my own. I spend a lot of time with just like a few people that I really love. I love writing, I love reading, and a lot of my actor friends are like that. But, you know, being on set and being in front of a camera or writing or directing, that's a completely different world that I love being part of more than anything else.
Wow. Like, I can get inspired from this. Can you tell us about your TED Talk? Tahmina had a really interesting TED Talk.
A lot. And then it got me thinking, what if I look at it from a different perspective? So I found solace in self-help books that spoke about the law of attraction.
So I got into meditation and just mindfulness. I think early on, I think when you are in the profession of an actor or a filmmaker, you quickly realize that there's a lot of rejection, there's a lot of no's, and you have to find something that's going to keep you grounded. And for me, it's been turning to a lot of these great writers and spiritual leaders that, you know, speak on matters that are kind of, I don't know how to say it without sounding pretentious, but the truth, really, the truth of how life works and what it is, you know, impermanence and how everything passes and all of that. And I read the book by Michael A. Singer. It was called The Surrender Experiment. And I think at that point I was in a meditation class at this great place inside LA. It's a nonprofit organization. They have incredible meditation classes there. And I remember I was next to, and I was the youngest person there, obviously. I was always like the younger person in all these spiritual communities. And there's this man, a really sweet man to me, and he said something about, I'm gonna take a class in surrender. And I don't know what it was, but that word really clicked with me. For some reason, there was something about that word that was really, really catchy. So I went home and I remember I was just like, it was stuck with me. And I think everything happens for a reason in life. And that book came into my life, The Surrender Experiment. I read it and I knew that this was something that came to me for a reason. And it was because up until that point, I was so stressed. I mean, I'm not saying I'm perfect now, but I was so stressed out about like, the grind. I think like we're taught that we need to constantly make an effort and really grind to get at something. And it's true. We do have to be hardworking people. But the idea of surrender is that you you do the, your best and then you let go. And once you surrender, everything in life comes to you. And, you know, he spoke about the experiment that he did, which is in his life, he just basically accepted everything that came his way. Like, not like bad things, but just like any opportunities, challenges. And he surrendered to them and like trusted the flow of life. And that was when I was like, let me give that a try. You know, in a career, in an industry where I have to control things, where I'm not in control, where I'm constantly waiting for someone to be told, to tell me if I'm good enough, if I got the part, if my script is going to be get made, if I'm going to be able to make a movie. I think this was something that really stuck with me. And I really leaned on to that. And from there on, really, I've been constantly working on my spiritual life, because it's the only mm-hmm. thing at the end of the day that really grounds me. It's the only thing that I feel like is kind of takes off the veil of illusion that we carry in this world. And as if when you're an actor and you're a filmmaker, especially, there's a lot of illusion. There's a lot of, you know, I think you just think this is the world and it's all that matters, but it's not. And like, I'm not going to get too much into it because I can talk hours about this, but it really grounded me. And I did this talk about like the power of surrendering mm-hmm. and anything, whoever you are, if you only trust the flow of life, if you only surrender and let go, you will see that better things will come into your life. Like holding on to something and like really kicking into a door sometimes is not the right thing to do. You just got to sometimes like back off.
I really like this. Which from fear, which book would you love to make a film out of one day if you had to?
Ooh, I actually, The Orientalist. Have you ever read it? So it's about Lev Nussbaum, who is Kurban Said, Ali Amino. So the writer of The Orientalist is Tom something. Can't remember his last name now. But anyways, The Orientalist. It's a New York Times bestseller. It's about the author of Ali Amino, Lev Nussbaum, which was his real name, by Kurban Said. And I just think it's a fascinating story. It's just the era, it covers everything from the oil boom era to just like what happened to him and his life story. I just think it's a fascinating story. And because I am very drawn to Azerbaijani stories and history, I think anything to do with the oil boom would be a really great thing to write, to make a movie about. Because we don't really have those movies. We haven't really made movies.
No, we don't. Yeah.
And I think it's such a great era.
Well, that would be great to see one day.
Yeah.
And let's see. Do you have a style of like the kind of movies that you would go, or like the ones that you definitely wouldn't play in? Like, do you have this?
As an actor, no. I don't think I have a thing where I'm like, no, I wouldn't do this or that. I think I have genres that I'm more drawn to, but as an actor, I'm really open to anything. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
And whose styles I really admire more and would love to work with. But overall, I think I would love to work as an actor. I mean, as a director and a writer, I probably have a more more of a style, yeah.
Okay. And what can you suggest to young talents who want to follow your steps, who want to go in this filming industry? I don't know, like, what can you tell them? I know this is a very difficult topic.
It is not easy, but if you want to do it, and if there's nothing else, if you can look deep into it yourself and find the reason why you want to do it, and it has nothing to do with fame, it has nothing to do with earning a lot of money, because trust me, you're probably going to have neither of those, because that's just how, you know, let's be honest.
You're going to spend more than actually earning at the in the beginning.
Yeah. I mean, you're going to spend more than you're probably going to earn. If you're lucky, you will become a working actor or filmmaker. But overall, it's like a very difficult thing to do. But if you're doing this because you truly love it and you truly feel like you have a voice in it, either as an actor, as a writer, as a director, or really anyone as an artist, you have to do it because that's what your soul wants. And I'm someone who really believes that you have to follow your heart. And Joseph Campbell said, follow your bliss. And I think that's one of the greatest things that anyone ever said. And I truly believe in that. If it truly brings you bliss, like I said, not for fame, not for money, because that's probably something you're not going to get. Just go for it. Do it. You know, take classes, meet people, watch a lot of movies on your own, study, you know, learn, even if you can't afford to study abroad, that's okay. You don't have to study abroad to be a filmmaker or an actor. You can do that on your own. You can watch a lot of great movies, buy a lot of books that talk about them, go online.
Yeah, I think nowadays, like, especially, it's so much easier with social media, with YouTube, with Instagram, yeah. Even like you can, I think, slowly somehow start to post something short.
Huh? And if you, you know, if you speak easier because there's a lot more things online if you speak English, but even if you don't, there's a lot of things that you can find in your own language. There's also a great streaming platform. It's called Masterclass. You can take classes with a lot of great people like David Lynch. I think it was, who else was on it? David Lynch is on it. A lot of other really fantastic directors. I'm blanking out now, but it's basically a subscription service where you pay for it and then you can take those classes. And it's great. It's truly, truly wonderful. I mean, you don't get the experience of actually making movies, but just the things that you hear and you learn are really valuable. And I truly believe that you should listen to the people that have paved the way for you, because they, you know, there's a reason why they've made it this far.
So yeah, you guys, if you are still interested in the filming industry, continue. Don't give up. I mean, from Tahmina,
but no, it's gonna be hard. Just know that, like,
it's hard, and like, it's amazing that you never gave up and you were surrounded by great people. I hope you will always be by wonderful people. Yeah.
Look, like, compare myself to an everyday person, because I do have support from my family morally, and you know, I did have financial support. So I will not say that, like, everyone can do this, but I also know that I also, you know, have a lot of friends and people who, like, literally had to sleep in their cars, and they love it so much that they can't imagine themselves doing anything else in their lives. And now they're, you know, they're not like millionaires, but they're making money by doing what they love. So that's all that matters. Yeah,
definitely. No, I agree. Like, always exploring, trying, not giving up. It's not easy, especially like in your field, you said you get so many rejections. I think it's more than what we get like in real life with other jobs. You know what?
Like, the hardest part is that it's literally like you go for an audition, which is, you know, like, what is it? A job interview is equivalent to a job interview. You go in there, you give your all, and then they're like, great, thank you. And me, what, like 99% of the time, you don't hear back. Oh, and God. You have to learn not to take it personally, that really it is about they have something in mind and you just don't. And to learn to not take things personal. Look, I still take things personal a lot, but you got to kind of learn. And the better you get at it, the easier it's going to be for you. But look, I still struggle. I still struggle a lot, but that's why I write. That's why I direct, because I find that it gives me more control. And I like that, because I also love writing. I love directing. So why not do that as well?
And it's not like, I mean, in our case, like for jobs, like we apply, you know, you just go on LinkedIn. You either click apply or send CV, but this is you physically to go there to audition.
Absolutely. And also, you know, for you, it's more like, do you have the skills? And you're like, yeah, I have the skills. With acting, it's not always about having the skills. There's a lot of great actors out there that are going to walk into audition and maybe even give a better audition than the person that gets the part. But, you know, they didn't look right. They weren't dark enough. They weren't light enough. Their hair wasn't red enough. Like, it's so much about how you look as well. And it's not saying like you have to be beautiful, but you have to fit what they have in their mind about like what the character is.
I see. Yeah. Well, really, thank you so much. I mean, on Instagram, I wish I could go on. Like, I still have a lot of questions. I'll probably ask them later. But Instagram gives us only 1 hour, unfortunately. And it's just like,
fine. I'm so sorry for all the tech problems. I don't know. Always happening, but I'm glad that we made something.
Yeah, definitely. Hopefully I'll post more about it. So thank you so much for coming and telling us about your journey, and I really wish best of luck to you. We're looking forward to all your movies, hopefully to go online. A lot of people are asking about that as well, so
thank you.
Thanks a lot. If you have anything else, and then we have 1 minute only.
No, thank you so much for just talking to me. That was really great.